should I say hello and g'day. Welcome to another one of my map drawing videos. For this video, I'll be chewing gum and I'll be chewing a piece of Wrigley's juicy fruit gum, and they come in these great little silver packs. You know, half the fun is just opening them up and finding the very slim piece of gum inside. Slim, long, and slender. So I'll pop that gum in my mouth and begin the video. So, Russia. Celsius is the coldest probably it gets in Sydney, western suburbs of Sydney, overnight in the winter. But if you you get a cold night, you'll often get a nice sunny warm day heating up to 16-17 degrees is a common daytime maximum. Probably 12 would probably be the, you might get that a couple of times a year where you get 12 degrees in, this is Sydney I'm talking about, as the lowest winter daytime temperature. Anyway, I'm not talking about Sydney or Australia. I should be concentrating on my map of Russia. Now down here, and then there's big interesting sort of peninsula down there, which I suppose goes to about there. It's a little bit wide and comes up to a point. And down here, this is the Sea of Okhotsk. I suppose that's how you pronounce it. And round in like that. Marked on my map, but where Manchuria is. Anyway. Okay, that's sort of the western border then. So over here in the east, this is all ocean here. And up here you've got Alaska, roughly about there somewhere. So it's surprisingly close between Russia and the USA. There's just a bit of water in between. Okay, so we'll go down here. This is Finland over here, and Sweden and Norway. And we're just going down around here. There's other countries in there. There's the Ukraine down there. forests following there at all, or mountain range perhaps. It's a big interesting looking border, up and down and around, something like that. Maybe it's a little bit further down, and then I'll go back around. This is some Mongolia, the border between Russia and Mongolia, and I'll fill all those in as the video progresses. And oh, okay, now I'm gonna come up there like that, and in and around and down. I've not quite got that right there, but still, that's not too bad actually. There's different there's some islands here like this. That's Japan, or that's still part of Russia. I'll fill that in. There's an interesting island that looks something like that up the top here. And there's another islands there, but I don't have a name for all those. So we've got Norway going around like that, and Finland, probably like that, and you've got Sweden in there as well. So, I'll write Russia in the middle, so you know where Russia is. Surprisingly large. And I'll write the other countries in down here. You've got China, Mongolia, now Kazakhstan. And there's China back down there as well. And you've got Finland, Norway, and Sweden there. Got more countries over there. This, where is that roughly? There is the Ukraine, I think. And there's more countries in there, but I'm not sure what they are actually. But that doesn't matter. Well, that's I suppose to them. But so what I'll do is I'll start using my light blue pencil to colour in the ocean around the northern border of Russia. Russian is the official language of Russia. Okay. Now up here, there's not really a lot happening up here. This is all. Not many people would live up here, I'd imagine. It'd be too cold and too far from anywhere else. A number of comments, a number of requests to do Russia, so I'm doing it now, and hopefully I'll do Russia justice, and hopefully those people will like my video, or this video. Keep going around the edge here, they've got Alaska up about here somewhere, that I said before, so surprisingly close to Russia, USA and Russia, in fact, going over the lines there, unfortunately. Stretched right across the top of China, but I probably didn't, and other countries, but I probably just didn't really appreciate how big it was. And I think it's the largest land area, country by land area, in the world. I think that's in my stats. I've got that in my stats somewhere. And there's Japan over here, but I won't draw Japan in. It's North Korea. I put NK there, SK for North Korea, and South Korea. And there's a little bit of ocean or sea around there, a little bit. This is the Caspian Sea down here, so I'll give that a little bit of a colour in. And what did I write? Caspian Sea. Arctic Ocean up the top, and I'll keep going around these islands just to finish off. There we go, Russia. I'm not sure what these islands are called, these little islands here. I'll go around the islands. Just as bits of circles on the map, but I suppose they've got more sort of shape and distinction to them in real life. Okay, now to colour in the main part of Russia, I'm going to do it red, and I guess red, I was thinking what colour should I do it, and red obviously stands out well for on the page, so it looks distinctive, and I suppose that's a little bit of a reflection, is that right word, or recognition is probably the word I'm looking for, of Russia's communist past. No longer a communist state, but it was a communist state for 70 odd years, or maybe not quite 70. Red for the commies, or the communists, I should say. Do people still call people commies now? That was probably something from the 1950s, perhaps. And people, they probably still call names, I suppose. I don't know. Not that there's anything wrong with being a communist. So there we go, there's the eastern border, and obviously Napoleon marched his armies up here. Not sure how far he got in the end, but up towards Moscow. Adolf Hitler marched his armies up towards Moscow, but I think they both in the end were repelled, I suppose, is the best word to describe that. Keep going around the borders here for Russia. And doing quite well, I don't think. Haven't had any outside noise so far, so having a good run on this video. You might notice on some of my other videos there's a lot of editing in them, where I've cut out background noise for different things, planes, birds, trucks. But so far, so good. I think I've just got one bit of editing to do, so it's good. Anyway, up here into the corner. I keep going around here. This is the Bering Sea over here on the right. I suppose I should write that in. Bering Sea. Not the typical way it's spelled Bering. B-E-R-I-N-G. And keep going down along here. Big long peninsula. Going over the blue. I've gone outside the lines. Shape nicely, and this is the Sea of Ok, Okhotsky, Notsk. I think that's, I have no idea how to pronounce that, but I've had a crack at it. Sea of Okhotsk. And keep going down here. I've got one lone town. I've really sort of gone to town with this sort of shading, and I don't know if it's really that good or not. I'm just trying to do it a bit slower and press a bit harder and get the colour down onto the page. There we go. So that's the map. Now it's okay. So finished. And that's done and colored Russia. It might be a little bit sort of wider up there perhaps, but it's not too bad. is about there. I should be doing it in. Oh, it's a bit hard to see, but anyway, the point there is for St. Petersburg. Now, Stalingrad is down here. About there, I think there's a river there. It was, looks like it was called Stalingrad. Now it's called Volgograd or something, I'm not sure. Anyway, I'll just call it Stalingrad. Because everybody's heard of Stalingrad, but I suppose most people have heard of Stalingrad. But I don't know that I've heard of Volgograd. It's almost like Volvo. Volgograd. Oh, and I just realised there's a name for this island, which is Novaya Zemla. It's the name of that island. And there's a town up here called Murmansk. It's an interesting. Now, where's that? Probably about there somewhere. Maybe it's there. There's a town. I think that looks like that's spelled Berm, B-E-R-M, Berm. Must be where the. Might be a lot of hairdressers, perhaps, in Berm. Or perhaps not. No, I've got the Caspian Sea down there. And there's other different rivers. There's lots of rivers all the way through. Through Russia. Okay, now what's interesting about Russia? I think that's the map pretty well done. Oh, I better write Barents Sea up there. Now what's interesting about Russia? Russia is called the Russian Federation. It's a, I'm pretty sure it's a democracy. It was obviously communist rule from 1922. 1991, when the communism dissolved. I suppose I can write them here. The population, 143 million. We already know it's the largest country, largest land area, country by land area in the world. And there's 9 different time zones all the way across Russia because it's so wide. There's 9 different time zones. Australia has three time zones. Oh, yeah. Spreading over 2 hours. The 9 might spread over. I'm not sure how many hours. Might be 5 to 10 hours. The Kremlin is in Moscow. The Kremlin is actually a building, a house for the Russian president, and it means fortress, and located in Moscow. And at the moment, Vladimir Putin is the president of Russia. And I always like the way Donald Trump pronounces Putin. It's sort of a Putin, like it's a poo tin, like that. And there's that man who imitates him, Alex Baldwin, I think it might be, that I've seen him. He's really emphasised the poo Putin. But anyway, I shouldn't really be commenting on those sort of things. But anyway, I guess it's kind of interesting. Now, the Volga River is the longest river in Russia. It's over here in the east. Like it might go through Moscow and come out over here in the ocean here in Volgograd in the Volga River. Maybe that's why they've renamed that from Stalingrad to Volgograd. And course, the world's first satellite was launched by the Russians in 1957, I think it is. 1957 was the Sputnik. And Russia hosted the Summer Olympics in 1980. The Olympics in 1980. And Australia and a lot of the Western world boycotted those Olympics. And they had the World Cup last year, 2017 Football World Cup in Russia. And as I recall, Russia did reasonably well, better than was expected. Football is one of their most popular sports, including and also basketball and ice hockey. We know there's 143 million, but unfortunately, 12 million people in Russia. Is it 12 million? I think it might be 17 million. And 12% of people live below the poverty line. So this, it's not really a great country to live in if you're not sort of skilled and can find yourself a well-paying job. So 40 national parks. It's got the world's largest forests are in Russia, which I'm guessing they're over here, and still pretty well untouched by civilization in the last part. The Ural Mountains are here. Where are they? The Ural Mountains are there. And that's about it. So, I've covered all the main things now. So, in Russia, so I'll finish up now and say, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you found it relaxing.